As we learned about the conventional sources of energy and how electrical energy is obtained from various kinds of energy, the main source of energy is fossil fuels. The rate at which these fossil fuels are used, one day will come when they will become extinct. Then from where we will get the energy? Have you ever thought of it? There are other sources of energy too, which are known as non-conventional sources of energy. Non-conventional sources of energy are those sources of energy in which new ways are incorporated to obtain energy from one form to another. These are renewable sources of energy that are continuously replenished by natural processes. They are majorly of four types: solar energy, energy from the sea, geothermal energy, and nuclear energy. Let's understand each source one by one. As we all know that sunlight is present in abundance in India, do you know that we can convert the solar energy into electrical energy? To convert this energy, solar cells of silicon are kept in the sunlight. These cells help in collecting the energy and store it in a battery. Then this energy can be used later. In cities, people do implant solar panels on their terrace. Then the energy stored are used to run various devices. This method of converting energy has a high initial cost, but in the coming years, consumption can increase. Second form of energy is obtained from the sea. Likewise, we learned about the hydropower plant in our last video. Here too, there are three kinds of sources: tidal energy, wave energy, and ocean thermal energy. In tidal energy, due to high and low tides near the shores of the ocean, turbine rotates, and with the help of the generator, electricity can be produced. In wave energy, a huge pipe is placed near the shore of the ocean. Due to the motion of the wave, the air pressure in the pipe increases and decreases, and the turbine blades gets rotated. In ocean thermal energy, rays coming from the sun fall on the ocean and make the uppermost layer hot and increase the temperature of that layer. Conversely, the lower layer of water is still cold. This change in temperature is used to rotate the blades of the turbine. A plant is placed in the ocean having an evaporator and a condenser. Pipe is filled with liquid ammonia. Ammonia is sensitive towards the change in temperature. When it comes in contact with the hot water, liquid ammonia converts into vapor and helps in rotating the blades of the turbine. When it goes down near the condenser, it gets condensed and the cycle repeats itself. Third one is geothermal energy. You must have seen or heard about the boiling water or steam coming out of the earth. This water comes out because of the temperature difference. Let's go a bit deeper to understand this concept. Hot magma is present in the core of the earth. Due to the motion of tectonic plates, it heats up the rocks just above it. When the groundwater converts into the steam, after coming in contact with these rocks, it starts moving towards the earth's surface. When it reaches the earth's surface, it is pumped out in the form of boiling water or steam. The steam is used to rotate the blades of the turbine by passing it through a particular area, a pipe in this case. With the help of the generator, the mechanical energy of the turbine can be converted into electrical energy. The last source of energy is known as nuclear energy. They are of two types: nuclear fission and nuclear fusion. Let's understand Einstein's E is equal to mc square equation first to understand this. Einstein equated two equatable quantities, energy and mass. Einstein stated that the mass can be converted into energy and vice versa. Let's understand this closely. If a heavier nucleus such as uranium is taken, due to size, the unstable nucleus of the uranium will try to become stable. To stabilize this, a low energy neutron is bombarded with it, then we will get two stable nuclei. In this process, a huge amount of energy is released, which can be used to obtain electrical energy. The combined weight of these two nuclei will be lesser than the former one. This means an amount of mass has been converted into the energy. In the second case, fusion takes place. Here two lighter nuclei fuse with each other to form a heavy nucleus. Like hydrogen, nucleus are fused to form helium. Due to the repulsion between the hydrogen nuclei, formation of helium is only possible at higher temperature, say more than 10 to the power 6 Kelvin. This kind of temperature can't be possible on Earth. But if we see the Sun, this kind of temperature is possible. Fusion takes place on the Sun commonly. The remaining nuclear energy is dangerous to human life and the environment. That is why when nuclear energy is obtained, people take care of safety first. We are among the tiniest in the whole universe, but our brain is not. Invention and discoveries are the example of using human brain at the right place. Likewise, the brain is the cause of destruction as well. We should acknowledge our duty towards nature and keep working in a direction to make this world a better place for everyone.